Blessings to everyone in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So I'm happy to be with you. Today God will speak to you, I believe. So with much faith, let us receive the Holy Spirit. Let Holy Spirit come in fullness. Let the power of the Holy Spirit come and fill us in fullness. And let God bring changes to our lives. So I welcome everyone, those who are watching. I thank Brother Richard and all sisters, every brothers, all those who are watching this live video. God is going to speak into your hearts. So I am very thankful to God for bringing me this opportunity to come before you. So today God is going to speak. Hallelujah. Something great is God is going to do in your lives. The financial area is going to be blessed. And many opportunities are opened. Especially great things are doing in your life. Welcome Sister Carol Smith, Sister Charlotte Downs, Brother Richard. Hallelujah. So the more you are intimated with God, the more blessing you will get. Hallelujah. How much more you are close to God, the more blessing you will get. Hallelujah. So God is bringing many changes in your family, in your life. So today morning I was reading the book of Philippians chapter 3. So I'm going to share with you from the 10th verse of chapter 3. So before coming into this message, let us close our eyes to pray. Father, I submit this live video before you. Let there be clarity in every sense, and you give me a revelation prophecy. May the power of God be released. The name of Jesus be exalted. Lord, touch everyone. Thank you, Lord, for bringing everyone to watch this live video. May Holy Spirit speak and deliver everyone and let them get all the blessings. In the name of Jesus. Only the name of Jesus be exalted. Amen. Hallelujah. So I welcome everyone, Sister Remya Rai and everyone. So I am reading one verse. It is from the book of Philippians. The book of Philippians chapter 10. It says, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being conformed to his death. That I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings. Hallelujah, being conformed to his death, if by any means I may attain to the resurrection from the dead. Hallelujah. So here it is saying, Paul counted everything loss. He counted all other things in this world, everything which the people counted as much value, Paul counted everything loss for the sake of Jesus, to know Jesus, to know the power of Jesus. Hallelujah. So if you walk with Jesus, it doesn't mean that you know Jesus completely. I tell an incident. The disciples of Jesus were walking with Jesus, but they didn't understand the power of Jesus. That's why when they were in the boat, when heavy tempest and storm came, they began to cry. They were frightened and they shook Jesus and said, "We are going to die." Because they were walking with Jesus. All the time they are staying with Jesus. Hallelujah. So they are all the time with Jesus, but when any problem came in their life, they did not understand who Jesus is, or they could not understand the power of Jesus. They didn't realize that Jesus could calm the sea. Jesus could command the waves to come still, but they didn't understand. So it doesn't mean that if any person is going to church, he knows Christ. No. It doesn't, if any person is reading Bible, we cannot say that he knows Jesus. But if you want to know Jesus, Paul is saying that he counted everything loss for the sake of Jesus, to know Jesus. I will read it from, hallelujah, I will read it from 7. But what things were gained to me, these I have counted loss for Christ. Hallelujah. Yet indeed I also count all things loss for the excellence of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things and count them as rubbish, that I may gain Christ and be found in him, not having my own righteousness which is from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ, but the righteousness which is from God by faith, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being conformed to his death, if by any means I may attain to the resurrection from the dead. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It is a nice verse. So Paul is saying that he wanted to know the power of Jesus. So to know the power of Jesus, he counted everything as loss, everything as secondary. He didn't give primary to anything, any other things other than Jesus. So if you want a deliverance, if you want a blessing from the Lord, you must give first preference to God. You must give everything first preference to your life, everything to God, then God will bless you. Today Paul is saying that he counted everything, what that were gained to him, he counted everything for the sake of Jesus, to know the power of God, to know the sufferings of Jesus. Why he wanted to know? Why he wanted to know the power of God? Hallelujah. So if you want a deliverance from God, you want to know who God is. If you want to understand the power of the God, you must have to reject everything. You must have to sacrifice everything for God. Then only God will be able to do something in your life. You know, God called all the Israelites. God called all the Israelites. But only few were able to enter the promised land, because most of them were not able to understand the power of God. They could not understand God completely, God, because when they were in the Red Sea, before the Red Sea also they cried. Every time when they were put in the test, they cried, because they have never understood the power of God. So look at the life of David. When he was in front of Goliath, Goliath was a big giant, and all the Israelites were afraid to fight with him. But this young David had the courage to fight with Goliath. Why he had the courage? Because he had known the power of God. How he had known the power of God? When he was looking after the sheep in the forest, once a lion came and the power of God came upon David, and David was able to kill that lion. So he had experienced the power of God. So if you know who God is, you are delivered. If you know who God is, you are already being delivered, and God is going to bless you in this season. So count everything lost for the sake of Jesus, and God is going to multiply you, and everything is coming in installment. Abera, Eherabat Ahara. Holy Spirit is saying everything is coming in installment, not in fully, step by step you are going to get. You are going to get it step by step, not in fully. So when it comes step by step, many times, don't think that you are not going to get it, because you are going to get it fully. So what I was ministering there, Paul counted everything loss to know Jesus. If you want to know Jesus, if you want to get a blessing from God, you have to count everything loss for the sake of Jesus. So today, this time, maybe you are in your country, it is locked down, but the Lord who called you is able to make you reach the destination. So you have to know the power of God. Jesus said to Peter, come and walk on the sea. So what happened? He did not understand the power of God fully. So when he saw the waves, everything came negative in his mind and he was about to drown. So maybe the financial situation is very big. When you look into your financial area, you might be thinking, how I will overcome, how I will run the ministry, how I will complete the project. You might be wondering, but if you know the power of God, the power of God will create many things. The power of God can multiply many things. How many of you say amen? Hallelujah. So the disciples, Jesus said the disciples, you give some food to the people who have come, they have been with us for 2 days. The disciples said, we do not have any food. Jesus said, bring what you have. And they brought 2 fish and some bread. But by the power of God, it was multiplied. So if you know the power, if you, maybe your financial area is very weak. You have many, many projects in your mind. You have many, many projects in your heart and you wanted to complete that project. You want to travel, you want to complete the construction, but the financial area is very weak. But if you know the power of God, there will be a multiplication. I see a multiplication in every area of your life. How many of you understand? There is a multiplication in your life. When the power of God comes into you, into your life, you will see the visions very accurately. And whatever that is completely not cured, it is going to be cured completely. I see the bronchitis and the breathing problem healed in the name of Jesus by the power of God. Hallelujah. How many of you understand? How many of you understand? Hallelujah. So Paul counted everything loss to gain Jesus, to know Jesus and the power of his resurrection. Hallelujah. So how many of you know the power of Jesus? Hallelujah. He was crucified and he was placed in a tomb, and the Roman soldiers sealed the tomb and nobody could come near the tomb and take the body. So they sealed the opening of the tomb. So what happened? So when the power of God came upon Jesus, he came out of the tomb where it was sealed. Today this time, maybe your everything is sealed by the devil, but when the power of God comes upon, the seal will be broken and you will be safe. Hallelujah. So if you rely on Jesus, if you rely on the power of God, many, many things are going to happen in your life. Hallelujah. Shakama. God is going to extend your boundaries. Sister Rebecca Cassie, God is going to extend your boundaries. I see you are going to the next place where you are residing and you are going to do the projects there in the next place. I sense like that. By the power of God, by the grace of God, you are going to see many, many things in your life. How many of you say, I believe that you know what is the power of God. Hallelujah. It will create many things. Hallelujah. You know, there was a woman, a widow, she was about to die because of starving and she wanted something to eat and she had no money. But a prophet came, his name was Elisha. Elisha came to her and asked, what you have? She said, I have a little oil. And when all the jars were brought according to her faith, the oil began to be poured without stopping. It began to pour without stopping. So when there is power of God, whatever you have, it will be multiplied even without your knowledge. If you believe, maybe you are watching this live video, but if there is something in your home, something there in your almara, something in your pocket, something in your purse, even without your knowledge, when the power of God comes upon you, it will be multiplied. I tell you that there was a man, Obed-Edom, without his knowledge, God began to bless Obed-Edom because the Ark of Covenant was kept there. How many of you understand? Hallelujah. So if you know Jesus, if you know the fellowship of, if you know the sufferings of Jesus, if you have the fellowship with Jesus concerning the sufferings, God will multiply you. God will bless you. Hallelujah. Oshakanaba, in the name of Jesus. So I'm going to pray for you. How many of you believe that the power of God will bring changes to my life? The power of God will bring changes to my family. The power of God will bring changes to my ministry. maybe you are a pastor. You do not have any place of worship, place of your own. Maybe you are in a rented place. Or you are a businessman doing the business in a rented place. But if you believe in God, the power of God will come upon you and create many things, and you will have the place of your own. God told Abraham, Abraham, you walk from day to evening. How much you walk, the whole place I will give to you. How much you walk, the whole place you give to me, give to you. God told Abraham, God told Abraham, Abraham, you look how much your eyesight go, that much land I will give to you. So when you have the power of God upon you, whatever you look, what all things you look, it will begin to multiply. How many of you believe? Hallelujah. It will begin to create. So don't worry about. You just think about the power of God, and you think about God and think about Jesus. There will be a miracle happening in your life. Hallelujah. But what happened to the Israelites? They began to see the negative things very much in their life. When they were sent to look the place sent by Moses, what they said, 10 of the people said, they saw that there were big giants. But what Caleb and Joshua said, they said, they are nothing, but our God is greater. So if you believe in God, if you count everything for the sake of Jesus as lost, so God will going to honor you. God is going to multiply you. God is going to increase the anointing upon you. So many, many great things are going to happen in your life. How many of you understand? Hallelujah. So once again, I'm reading that. Paul is saying that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering. So here Paul is saying that he wants to know the fellowship of his suffering. Why he wants to know the fellowship of his suffering? Because if you are passed through many trials, if you are going through many wilderness, if your life is not very smooth, don't be dismayed, don't complain, don't murmur, because God is leading you through such circumstances to know Jesus, to know the power of God. That's why in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4, for 6th verse, it is saying that everything, all the blessings are now placed in earthen vessels in order to know that it is not your own, that it has not you are brought from your home, and it has been given to you by grace from God. So that's why everything is placed in earthen vessels. So if you have any pain in your body, do not worry. If you are passing through any wilderness, don't be upset. If you are going through many, many difficulties, don't be upset, because it is God allowing such circumstances to know God, to know Jesus, to know the power of God. So when you know the power of God, everything will be created. Hallelujah. Shakabara. In the name of Jesus, I see everything. God is in control of everything. Sister Polia Winlock, I see a multiplication in your life. I see a get together in your life. Very soon you are going to be in the place, in the right place where your heart is desiring. So I see get together, and all the things are coming in favorable to you because of the grace of God. The power of the Lord is coming upon you. Don't be dismayed. Hallelujah. Whatever things that is negative in your life, God is going to bring it positive by the grace of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So when the anointing comes upon you, understand one thing. If you are a normal person, if you are put in a lions, then what happened? The lions will come and kill you. They will attack you and kill you. But if you are an anointed person, it means you have the power of God. What happens? There will be a wall of fire around you, and no lion, no snake, no enemy can come near you, because there is a wall of fire. That is the power of God. So you are protected from coronavirus. You are protected from all the contagious diseases. You are protected from all the evil plans of the enemy. You are, when there is tsunami, when there is earthquake, when there is any flood or anything happening in your area, it won't come to you. What is the guarantee? It is the guarantee that I have known Jesus. I have known Jesus. Not like the disciples who have not received the Holy Spirit, but I have known Jesus like the disciples after they have received Holy Spirit. So Peter was afraid when at the time of crucifixion Peter was afraid to come near Jesus, but when he received the Holy Spirit he had the boldness to say, let me be crucified with my head downward. So when the power of God come upon you, you will have much boldness. The enemy won't come near you because you have much boldness and you are much courageous and you have the power of God. So you have the grace of God. So now you are stepping into the next realm. How many of you understand? Things are going to create in your life. Whatever there is nothing in your life, understand one thing, if you know Jesus, if you know the power of Jesus, if you know God, if you know the power of God, and if you have fellowship with the sufferings of like that of Jesus, what will happen? Just knowing the power of God will bring deliverance. Just knowing the power of God will bring multiplication to what you lack. Hallelujah. So that's why, in order to know, that's what Paul is saying, to know Jesus, to know the power of God. For why you want to know? To attain resurrection. Hallelujah. To get the resurrection, to get the resurrection from the dead. He understood one thing, he wanted to know Jesus. Hallelujah. So if you want deliverance, hallelujah, I'm not telling you to fast for 40 days. Fasting is good. Fasting is good to for edification of the spirit. But if you want deliverance, you have to know Jesus. Hallelujah. Don't be like the disciples who were going with Jesus but did not understanding the power of God. But if you know Jesus, at the time things will going to be created. Jesus is always with you. Jesus is with you. He is having fellowship with you. He is inside you. The Christ, the hope of glory is inside you. So whatever you say, things will be happening. Your mouth will be like that of Jesus. So whatever you say, things are going to happen. So looking into your emptiness, looking in your empty purse, looking into your empty almara, refrigerator, everything, looking into whatever area there is emptiness, you open your mouth and say, let everything be created by faith. When God opened God's mouth and said, let there be sun, let there be moon, everything was created. How many of you understand? How many of you understand? So if you know the power of God, if you know Jesus, if you have counted everything lost for the sake of Jesus, what you command, it will happen. Elijah said, until I say, there won't be any rain. Because he knew the power of God. He knew who God was. So he said boldly before all the people. What he said? He said before the other kings, until I say, there won't be any rain. So let everyone say, I will not die, but I will declare the glory of the Lord. I will not die, but I will live longer and declare the glory of the Lord. I won't be affected by any coronavirus because I have known Jesus. I have known the power of God. So there is a wall of fire around me and you because I and you know Jesus. So Jesus is guarding us. I see the angels with swords in their hand to protect us. Maybe it is the disease is spreading everywhere. But if you believe, if you know Jesus, it won't come to you. Because thousands may fall, 10,000s may fall, but it won't come to you. Hallelujah. But it won't come near you because you know, you have known God Jehovah. You know who God is. You know who Jesus is. So I am going to pray for you. Hallelujah. So God is going to give a multiplication in your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let there be movement. Let there be a movement. Let the power of God come upon everyone's life and there be a movement in every area of your life. Hallelujah. Something is dismantling and something is created. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So, Charlotte Down sister, the grace of the Lord is coming upon you and you need not to be worried. Sister Ann Subhadri sister, I see God is healing you. God is healing you. The toothache healed. I see everything coming to be settled. So need not to be worried. Hallelujah. Focus on the things at heaven. And God is going to multiply you. God is going to establish you in the place where you are. Hallelujah. So a great change. Sister Bonnie Jean, sister, a great change is coming in your life. God is going to establish you in the place. Whatever you have lost, God is going to establish you in the same place. Hallelujah. I see an immediate appointment in your life. Hallelujah. It is going to happen. Hallelujah. So let us close our eyes and pray to God. So I encourage everyone to know Jesus, to know the power of God. If you know the power of God, when you look at whatever that is lacking, it will be multiplied because it is by the power of God. It is by your faith. Have the faith like that of Elijah. Elijah said, until I say it won't rain. So it happened like that. And again when Elijah said, let it rain, and God acknowledged it. So God is going to establish you. If you know Jesus, God is going to establish you like that God established Samuel. So today God is going to honor you. I'm going to pray for you. So need not to be worried. Hallelujah. Let us close our eyes. Father, in the name of Jesus, everyone, those who are watching this live video, let them know Jesus right now. Let them know Jesus as like that they have known Jesus, not like before, but let them know that Jesus is now inside them and Jesus is going to bless them and Jesus is going to lift them up from wherever they are and going to place them in a permanent position. So let them come to know Jesus. Hallelujah. Let the grace of God be upon them and let them know the power of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let them know the power of Jesus. Hallelujah. Touch everyone. God is healing everyone. So if anyone is having any disease on your body, you place your hand wherever you are. If you have any problem in your body, any pain in your body, any disease in your body, right now, if you know Jesus and you touch wherever it is, if you have any pain in your body, place your hand upon whatever pain is there, whatever disease, you place your hand and know Jesus and pray to God. Lord, I have known you. Lord, I have known you. Let the power of God come upon me and heal. Right now, the power of God is coming upon and healing everyone from all chest pain. God healing bronchitis, God healing arthritis. The power of God is coming upon and healing diabetes right now in the name of Jesus. The power of God is coming upon and healing all the skin disease, all the flu, all the cough, all the chest pain, all the infection right now are healed in the name of Jesus. God is healing everyone from all fear. God is comforting everyone right now in the name of Jesus. The power of God is coming upon your financial area and giving you a financial blessing. Let there be a multiplication from right now in the name of Jesus. Let them see, let their eyes see a wonderful things in the financial area, in their health. God's power is coming upon your family and your family is going to be blessed. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I protect everyone from the coronavirus. Build a fence around them. Let there be a safety in their life and let them be protected in every area of their life. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. So God is going to bless you. How many of you understand? So God is going to bless you in every area of your life. I see an increase in cattle. Hallelujah. In your domestic area. Hallelujah. So God's power is upon you. If you know who Jesus is, if you know the power of God, you just look into the area of what you are lacking and it will be blessed and it will be multiplied. Hallelujah. Even when you are sleeping, you will be blessed because the grace of the Lord. If you know Jesus, even when you are sleeping, you will be blessed. So do not be afraid. I thank everyone, those who are watching this live video. God's grace be upon you and God is going to bless you and increase in everything. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So God bless you. I will be going on live next week, same time in this group. May God bless everyone, those who have watched this live video. Jesus' name. Amen.